Hello, and welcome back to Google Developers Live. I'm Timothy Jordan here at Google I.O., and I'm sitting with a few friends who built something really fun for Glass. Now, the reason we brought these guys up here is because I think the story is so cool, and it's cool for a number of different reasons. The first one is that these three guys are from three different parts of the country. They all got together at our Glass Foundry here in San Francisco, built some really cool glassware, and won first prize. Not only that, the glassware that they built was based on fun and having a good time. It's the first game that we have for Glass, and I just wanted to talk about that in more detail. I think we should go through and just have you guys introduce yourselves, and how about this? Throw in also what's your favorite thing about the Mirror API. Let's start with Song.
Awesome. My name is Song, and I'm a developer evangelist at TalkBox. And I've been playing around with the Mirror API ever since the hackathon. And what I really like about it is that it's very easy to use, it's RESTful, and there's a lot of client support. So it doesn't matter which language you're using, there's support for it.
And Jonathan.
Hey, I'm John Gottfried, and I'm a developer evangelist at Twilio. And I've really enjoyed the fact that the Mirror API allows me to develop an application and not have to worry about the client, right? I can assume that my application is going to run as expected because of how it interacts with the Glass device.
Awesome. And Rajiv.
Hi, I'm Rajiv Makijani. I'm a software developer at Hulu. And I think the Glass API is really cool because it lets you develop what essentially feels like a client application the same way you develop a web app, so that, you know, you can release updates, make changes, and really affect it without having to worry about software updates or anything like that.
That's cool. Before we start talking about Icebreaker in more detail, now if you're playing the home game and you'd like to check out Icebreaker, go to icebreaker.io. Now it's going to be a lot more fun if you're here at Google I.O. with Glass, but if you'd like to take a look at their cool graphics and see what it's about, you can play along that way. Let's talk more detail about that, but before we do, let's talk about developing for Glass. Now, what I think is crazy about what you guys did was, we had this conversation a few weeks back, wouldn't it be cool if we took what you guys built for Glass Foundry and expanded it to a game that people with Glass at I.O. could play and could use to meet each other. And then you went off and running developing, and it was just, it was really fast iteration process, and I believe you're still submitting code, making it better. Now, what is it about the Mirror API? Hello.
You're
live on I.O., you know.
I'm not. I know.
Yes, you are.
What?
Yes.
Oh my God.
Just say hi. It's okay. Okay. That's going to go down in history. All right, so back to what is it about the Mirror API that makes doing that kind of development, that fast iteration and that like fly-by-the-wire development, so effective?
Okay, so what do you think, John?
So I think that the interesting thing is what Rajiv mentioned earlier, that the Mirror API is really a client application that you're developing in the style of a web application. So we are deploying code in Ruby and Python, right, that one runs on a web server, and the device simply connects to it in a natural way that we don't have to worry about, right? So we can write our code and deploy, you know, as often as we like and as often as we need to, mm-hmm. without having to interact with the devices themselves, right? We don't have to push an update. We don't have to have the user do anything. We can just write the code, deploy it to our server, and they will have the latest version. And it's really, really one of the things I love about web development, and it's awesome to see that ported to a client device.
That's cool. All right. You want to add something to that?
Yeah,
go for it.
I just wanted to say that the Mirror API, being RESTful and all, really fits the model of the whole concept of timeline, right? Mm-hmm. So you have a whole timeline on your Google Glass. When you send a post request, you create a timeline, and you send, if you send an update request, it updates it. Mm-hmm. It's working with the Mirror API, it's something that you understand right away, so you don't have to like do a whole paradigm shift and like learn an entire new framework. The whole concept of Mirror API was very natural and easy to pick up. Yeah. So,
awesome. Yeah. Okay, let's talk about the game. And I think this is really important because Glass is great for productivity. It's great for sending email, and there's also a lot of fun stuff you can do on Glass, like getting updates and sending pictures to my friends on Google+. But what I love about Icebreaker is just so filled with whimsy. Yeah, I mean, it's just you have a really good time playing the game and meeting new people at the same time. Rajiv, do you want to talk a little bit about like where that idea came from?
And, sure. Yeah.
You know, so, why it works at IO?
So the game kind of started in a different place. I mean, originally we were trying to model what we were building off of the game of Assassins because we thought, you know, it'd be cool to use Glass to do something like that. And, you know, later we realized that, you know, hey, this is actually an opportunity to be both a game and also a way to meet people so that, you know, Glass isn't just about productivity and receiving, you know, notifications about different information happening, but it's also a way to meet other people around you and actually keep you more in touch with the real world rather than sucking you back into your electronic devices. So we thought that would be a really cool way to approach it.
That's great. And what I love about that is that Glass isn't about being immersed in a device.
Yeah.
It's about connecting you more with the people and places around you. And I think Icebreaker does that really well.
And I think that while we're in the Explorer program, right, it's a very tight-knit group that's already collaborating online and already having all these interactions within, you know, the developer community. And it's awesome to kind of transmit that to the real world, right? It's already a small, tight-knit group of people, and it's awesome to see them meet and interact in person.
Yeah.
If I have Google Glass and you're wearing Google Glass, we have something in common right away. We're both passionate about technology, right? Yeah. So why not build an app that brings all our interests together so that you meet another person who also has the same passion for technology that you have and build a whole community like that. And as Glass expands, the community expands and everybody becomes a one big family.
I like that. Now, you've been at our sandbox over there in the Glass booth, and which means you've been demoing. People have been coming up and asking you questions, and you've probably also got some people with Glass who've started using Icebreaker. How's it going at the conference? Are people using it? Are they meeting each other?
Yeah, it's been great. I mean, you know, initially there's a little bit of Wi-Fi problems, but I think people have really started picking up and, you know, playing the game. We've seen a lot of people actually, you know, find people and meet people, and a lot of people would be really excited about it because, you know, it's one of the few interactive things you can do with Glass right now that is, you know, beyond just productivity. So I think it's been quite successful from our opinion.
That's awesome.
So I've been getting updates constantly. Hey, this person is close to you. Do you want to meet him? And so I've been asking random people, hey, are you Antonio? Are you Dave? And eventually I found my target. And then it happened to also be John's target. So we introduced him to Antonio. And we've never met each other before, but mm-hmm. We became friends right away.
All right, so we just have a couple minutes left. Let me ask you one short question, give me a quick answer. What do you think is next for Icebreaker? Do you think this is something that you might keep going with and people will keep using to meet each other?
So, I mean, I think we want to just explore, you know, where it goes, like, you know, see what people's feedback is based on using it, see how many people actually have Glass and are in the same proximity, and then, you know, we can consider either expanding it to other devices or if there's enough Glass devices, then maybe figuring out ways to recommend people that have common interests, you know, if like everyone has Glass or, you know, not necessarily everyone, but like a large percentage of people, then it'd be really cool to actually like introduce you to people that have other shared interests, not just that they have Glass, so.
Very cool.
I really think that as the developer tools expand for Glass and as we can start building more advanced features, that we're going to expand Icebreaker to match that, right? We really want to kind of be on the cutting edge of like Glass development, right? And we want our application to kind of embody like the best and the most interesting uses of Glass. And so I think that as we have access to more features and more functionality, we're going to integrate that into our app.
I think that as Glass becomes more mainstream and we start getting more people using it, we're eventually going to maybe add like interest fields, right? Mm. And map people with interest, same interest together.
That's cool.
And then once we are at that point, it would make sense to build an Android app goes along with it. So you don't,
awesome.
It welcomes other players as well.
Awesome. Well, thank you guys so much for joining me here.
Thank you.
And for building on Glass. And thank you out there for joining us. If you'd like to know more information about building on Glass, developers.google.com/glass. We're also answering questions on Stack Overflow and, of course, on Google+. This has been Google Developers Live at I.O. We'll be back at 6 p.m. with a talk with Gmail.